Good morning everyone. In this lecture we will study about the modulation and its necessity. What is the modulation? What is its necessity? We will discuss in this lecture. So our topic is modulation and its necessity. Okay, now what happened? We have small baseband signals of low frequency. We have baseband signal means message signal. We have message signals that is called baseband signal, which are of low frequency. So message signal are of low frequency and this message signal is spreads. Message signal is spread over the range of frequencies. So this is called signal bandwidth. So many factor affect when we transmit the baseband signal in the space. So because there is an issue of our purpose is to transmit our baseband signal efficiently, that do not destroy in middle in the path of transmission anyhow. So and there are many factors that affect the transmission information of the signals. Factor affect transmission of information signal. First is size of antenna. Size of antenna should be λ/4. If frequency is 20 kilohertz and lambda, then lambda will be 15 kilometer. So SC is equal to F lambda. As the frequency is increased, lambda will decrease. And lambda will decrease, the size of antenna will decrease. So direct transmission is not possible through the antenna. Second problem is here is that efficient power radiation by an antenna. We want to transmit a baseband signal with a good power so that it do not destroy in the middle of the transmission. So second problem is that power radiated by antenna. This power is directly inversely proportional to 1 upon lambda square. So for good transmission, high power is required, and high power when lambda is low, and lambda is low means high frequency. But in baseband signals, frequency is low. So for the increase of frequency, we used modulation. So we have required some carrier which carries the information, which carry our information and transmit. So carrier we use carrier signal of high frequency. So now we will discuss about what is the modulation. Modulation in what happen in modulation, carrier signal is changed according to the baseband signal. And carrier signal means carrier, if we write the carrier signal like कैरियर सिग्नल इक्वेशन साइन ओमेगा सी टी प्लस 5. सो दिस इज अ फेज, दिस इज एंगुलर फ्रिक्वेंसी, दिस इज एम्पलीट्यूड. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द मैसेज सिग्नल और बेस बैंड सिग्नल, एम्पलीट्यूड, एंगुलर फ्रिक्वेंसी एंड फेज, एनी ऑफ वन प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द कैरियर सिग्नल इज चेंज एंड सिग्नल इज ट्रांसमिटेड. दिस सिग्नल कैरीज द अवर इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कैरी अवर इंफॉर्मेशन एंड एट द रिसीवर साइड दिस इंफॉर्मेशन इज गेट. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस टाइप वी हैव थ्री टाइप ऑफ मॉड्यूलेशन. वी हैव थ्री टाइप ऑफ मॉड्यूलेशन. फर्स्ट इज एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन, सेकेंड इज फेज फ्रिक्वेंसी मॉड्यूलेशन, थर्ड इज पल्स फेज मॉड्यूलेशन. इन दिस एम्पलीट्यूड इज वेरीड, इन दिस फ्रिक्वेंसी ऑफ कैरियर सिग्नल इज वेरीड, इन दिस फेज ऑफ कैरियर सिग्नल इज वेरीड. तो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी ओनली एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन. एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन. सो सपोज वी हैव ए बेस सिग्नल, दिस वन, और मैसेज सिग्नल, एंड वी हैव ए कैरियर सिग्नल. This one is carrier signal. So in amplitude modulation, we change the amplitude of carrier signal according to the message signal. So I write here, equation of carrier signal is CT is equal to AC sine omega CT, and message signal is MT is equal to AM sine omega MT. Second equation. Now we can write modulated signal is as MT plus AC into sine omega C. This can be write as AM sin omega mt sin omega ct. Further, I take ic out from the bracket, am upon ac sin omega mt is equal to sin omega ct. Here am upon ac is equal to mu. So ac sin omega ct plus ac into mu sin omega t plus sin omega c. This can be write as ac sin omega ct plus ac mu by 2 cos omega c minus omega mt plus AC mu upon 2 cos omega C plus omega MT. So this is lower band signal and this is higher band signal or upper band signal. If I draw the spectrum diagram of this, I can draw it like amplitude on the y-axis and frequency, angular frequency on this axis. So here will be, this is the carrier frequency, this is a lower band and this is the upper band. This is mu AC upon 2 and this is called AC. And here omega c is equal to omega m, here omega c minus omega m. The separation between the upper band signal and lower upper band signal and the carrier signal, and carrier signal and lower band signal is significant, so that those signals do not get influenced with each other. So using this we get the signal, we modulated the carrier signal according to message signal. Now next topic is production of amplitude modulation wave. Modulated wave. How we will produce the modulated wave? So here, first of all, I will draw the diagram. This is MT, our message signal. This is our CT carrier signal. And here it is a square low device. Okay. Now here we will get YT, and this will be bandpass signal, bandpass filter. What is the bandpass filter? Bandpass filter is the electrical device which only pass the which allows the signal to pass a band of frequencies, that is for which it is used. So here it is, we get amplitude modulated waves, and here it is BXT plus CXT square. So YT will be BXT plus CT. When we will put the values, YT will be B, XT is AM sine omega MT plus AC sine omega CT, then plus C is AM sine omega MT plus AC sine omega C square. Finally, when we will solve it, we will get BAM sine omega MT plus BAC sine omega CT plus CA square upon 2M plus AC square plus CAM square upon 2 cos 2 omega MT. Next, minus CAC square upon 2 cos 2 omega CT plus CAM AC cos omega C minus omega MT minus CAM AC cos omega C plus omega MT. So here these terms are DC terms. These are DC term, and these terms will be these terms are not allowed to pass through the bandpass filter, because here the frequency is 2 omega C, double of the frequency 2 omega C and 2 omega C. Our bandpass filter is designed to pass only frequency band of omega C, means carrier band frequency. So it only pass the signals, this signal is नॉट पास, नॉट पास, दिस सिग्नल इज पास्ड, सो ओनली सम सिग्नल्स आर इज पास्ड, नॉट पास्ड, पास्ड, डीसी, नॉट पास, 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 सो हेंस वी विल गेट y इज इक्वल टू, वी विल गेट y इज इक्वल टू a ac sin omega ct plus mu ac upon 2 cos omega c minus omega mt plus sorry minus cos omega ct plus omega m. So it is our production of. Now the detection, next is detection of waves. Next, our next topic is detection of amplitude modulation. So next topic is detection of amplitude modulation. Amplitude modulation. We have earlier we have studied how we will get the amplitude modulated wave, and now after the receiving the signals, after the amplitude waves, AM wave, how we will detect our message from the amplitude modulated wave. So here is the block diagram of it. It here our receiver's antenna. This receives the signals and amplified, because receiver signals are very becomes less powerful due to the transmission or due to the after that IF stage. After that, signal go through the detector. After that, detected signals also amplified using the amplifier, and after that we get output, and this output amplitude modulated wave, this output modulated wave is inserted into the rectifier and then envelope detector is used to detect the baseband signal or message signal, and after it we get the message signal. So here it is how the this is our, and this is baseband signal, and this is carrier signal, this is AM wave, and here it get rectified. And here, this is like baseband, or this is our message. So, like that, we can. This is T. This is voltage. So, this is our detection of the signals. This is our detection of the amplitude. Thank you very much. Good morning, everyone.